there! Today, we're gonna talk about top-down and bottom-up decision-making.
First, let's look at top-down definition. So, what is top-down? We have two sources over here. Firstly, according to Merriam-Webster, top-down is an approach where an idea or decision is controlled or directed from the highest levels. It starts with a general idea and having details gradually added as it goes down the hierarchy.
Next, we have a definition from smallbusiness.crun. From this website, it is stated that top-down is a management style where heads of the organization makes the decisions and passes them down to the other members of the organization to implement.
Let's move along to the bottom-up definition. So, let me ask you again, what is bottom-up? We have definitions from the same sources, which are Merriam-Webster and smallbusiness.crun. So, according to Merriam-Webster, bottom-up is an approach where the idea and decision is controlled or directed from lower levels of hierarchy and then progresses upwards towards the top management, slightly different as compared to top-down. While from smallbusiness.crun, bottom-up management style is where the final decision is still made by the heads of the organization, but the idea giving and details are informed by the member surveys and by discussing realistic options with different departments in an organization. To put it simply, the idea is made from the members in the lower levels in the hierarchy, but ultimately, the end decision is still made by the head of the organization.
Next, let us go deeper into what exactly top-down is all about. First, let me show you some illustration of top-down. Well, generally, the top-down hierarchy is shaped like a triangle, whereby the pointy end on top represents the top management. The shape gradually widens, representing the departments and then ending with the employees of the organization. Here is an example of a hierarchy of an organization. We have the CEO on top who comes up with an idea or makes a decision. The idea or decision is then passed down to the vice presidents and then to the upper managements. Here, the details of the idea are perfected and confirmed before sending them down to the employees. The employees are at the bottom of the hierarchy and their main job is to execute the commands given by the management above them. In short, the guy on top does the thinking, while the people at the bottom add on and confirms the whole thing.
Now, let us take a look at the hierarchy for bottom-up management. Bottom-up management can be illustrated by an inverted triangle. Therefore, it is opposite of top-down management. Here, the employees are at the top. Ideas are generated by taking into account everyone's opinion and suggestions. These ideas are then passed on to the upper management to be filtered and completed. The vice presidents then take over. At the tip of the triangle, we have the CEO. Although people from the lower levels of the organization comes up with the idea, the final decision is still made by the CEO. But by comparison, ideas from the bottom-up management are more effective and complete, as many people helped to make the idea possible.
Now, we go on into the details of top-down management. In top-down management, the top-down planning efforts begin with the board of directors and the top executives of the firm or the management. In top-down planning, decisions are taken at the top of the management. Lower level managers have little input or no input at all, as the decision is taken by the CEO. Plans are passed down to the line for implementation. Planners are able to focus on strategic issues but can be divorced from the details as they only come up with the idea but not the implementation. The people from the bottom part of the management does the implementation.
Now, we go on to the details of bottom-up management.
In bottom-up planning, planning is initiated at the lowest level of the organization, usually by employees. For the bottom-up planning, it involves all levels of managers and other workers such as employees. This ensures that all are involved and all issues are considered before taking up a decision. Functional managers are able to suggest and evaluate plans from the employees before passing them up to the managers above. For this bottom-up planning, there is also a danger, which is having too narrow perspective without seeing the big picture.
Now let's move along to the advantages and disadvantages of the top-down approach. So, the advantages would be employees know their role, which levels the playing field. The disadvantages is loss of potential talent and impact on morale. Now, the bottom-up approach. The advantages would be ownership and participation of employees and motivation of employees. The disadvantages would be complexity and it's time-consuming. Therefore, in conclusion, comparing both top-down and bottom-up approach, bottom-up is the better approach in decision-making in a management organization.
Solution is my queen, cause she stays strong.